The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 4th chapter, text number 17, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on April 5th, 1974, in Bombay, India.
Translation. Even the intelligent are bewildered in determining what is action and what is inaction. Now I shall explain to you what action is. Knowing which, you should be liberated from all sins.
Kim karma kim akarma iti kavayopi atra mahita. Tatte karma pravakshame jat jatya mokshase asuha. So, again the same beginning, Chatutpannang Maya's system, Gunakarma Vibhagas. Everything is spoken on that basis. Now, everyone has to work. Krishna never says to Arjuna that you haven't got to work. I am your friend. I am the Supreme Personality of Godhead. You simply sleep and I shall do everything for you. He never said like that. He could say that, just like modern rascal incarnation of God, they say to their devotees, that you simply think of me, I shall do everything for you. But Krishna never said that. Krishna said that manmanabhav madbhakto marjari mahanamaskuru, but never said that you sit down idly. Never said that. Krishna rather said that you better do akarma than sit down idly. Even you do something mischievous, that is also good, than to sit down idle. He never said. Karmanne vadikaraste mahapalesh kadaja. Simply he said that you work. You have got the right to work according to your capacity, according to your position. That position is Brahmana position, Kshatriya position, Vaishya position, Shudra position, in any position, you work. But the result should be given to Krishna. That is one. That is tag. Tag means to give up the result to Krishna. That is sannyas. Sat, nyas. Sat means the Supreme. And anyone who renounces everything for Krishna, the Supreme, he is sannyasi. That will be explained in the 5th chapter. Karjam karma karotiya. Anasrita karma phalam. Karjam karma karotiya. Sa sannyasi. Karjam, it is my duty. Just like we have got in our institution specifies duties for each and every member, and they are doing, and if they take it seriously, every one of them, that it is the ordained duty. My Guru Maharaj has specified this duty upon me, so it is my duty. Karjam. Karjam means it is my duty. I must do it. So, anasrita karma phalam, karjam karma karo, that is trained up. According to varnasram dharma, that is trained up. A brahmachari from the very beginning of his life, he is trained to act only for guru. That is brahmachari. It is enjoined that a brahmachari live at the shelter, at the care of Guru, just like a menial servant. Krishna also, although he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, when he was living as brahmachari at his guru's house, Sandipuni Muni, he was collecting wood here from the jungle. He was going daily. It is not that because he was personality of Godhead, therefore he should not go. No. You will find in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Krishna book, that when Sudama, Vipra, met him, he was talking with him about his childhood stories. Krishna reminded him, Sudama, do you remember that one day we went to collect fuel for our Guru Maharaj, and there was storm and rain, and we could not get out of the forest. We had to leave overnight there. Then on the morning, Guru Maharaj came with other disciples, and they recovered us from the jungle. Do you remember? So Krishna had to do this. This is training. A brahmachari is trained up from the very beginning. How to become a sannyasi at the end of life? How he is trained up? He is trained up to collect for Guru alms everywhere. The brahmachari would go to householder and ask, Mother, give us some alms for my Guru Maharaj. And the ladies would give it, because everyone's son goes to the Gurukul, so there was no hesitation. And the brahmachari would collect and bring it in the ashrama. And then he should live just like a menial servant. He may be a king's son or a very learned Brahmin son, but when he lives at Gurukul, he has to work. It is said in the Shastra, in Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, you will find the duty of brahmachari, the duty of grihastha, the duty of vanaprastha, the duty of sannyas, everything is there. So a brahmachari is trained in such a way that although he has collected everything, but he does not claim anything. He does not keep anything with him. Even though he has to eat in the ashram, but that he will eat upon the calling by the Guru. My dear such and such, please come and take your prasadam. It is said, if the Guru forgets to call him one day, he will not take his food. This is called brahmachari. And they strictly following. And they used to call every woman from the beginning of life, mother. This is training. Matrivat paradhareshu. From the very beginning of life. All women have been treated as mother. That is the system, Vedic system. Everyone will call a woman as mother. Never mind whether she is younger or older, it doesn't matter. Woman has to be addressed as mother. That is Chanakya Pandit in his classroom. Who is learned scholar? Who has got three qualifications? He is learned scholar. What is that? Matrivat paradhareshu. To treat all women as mother. Nowadays it has been introduced in India, Bahinji. No. This is not the etiquette. The etiquette is to address every woman, never mind whether she is young or old, as mother. This is brahmachari. This is brahmachari. The brahmacharya is very strictly enjoined in the Vedic Shastra. Brahmacharya maintain. Brahmacharya, it is advised. Matra sasra duhitrava Navivatka. Matra sasya dhitrava. So one should not sit down with Oman in a secluded place. Even though the Oman is mother, sister or daughter. So much restriction. And why? Balavan Indiya Grama. The senses are very powerful. Vidhang Savikarsati. Our senses may be powerful for the fools and rascals. No. Vidhang Savikarsati. Even one is very learned and smart. Still, senses are so powerful that it can be agitated even before the mother, sister and daughter. This is Vedic injunction, Brahmacharya. Tapasa brahmacharyena, damena, samena. These are the human life. To accept brahmacharya life, tapasya, controlling the senses, controlling the mind, tagena, by giving in charity whatever you possess. These are the different processes. But if you take to bhakti yoga, then all these processes become automatically accustomed. That is the profit of bhakti yoga. Brahmachari karma, grihastha karma, vanaprastha karma, sannyas karma, then brahmanas karma, then kshatriyas karma, vaishyas karma, sudras karma. The society which knows perfectly well all these different karmas, that is perfect society, that is human society. That what Krishna says, that king karma vikarmayati kavayopi atra mohita. Kavayo, very learned scholars, they are also become bewildered. How to specify duty to a particular person? That is not being done at the same time. Everyone is going to the schools and colleges, passing their examination. But because he is not trained up according to his tendency or according to his quality, after education, he is unemployed. Because he has not been trained up according to the tendency, according to the qualification. That is the basic principle of karma. Krishna has begun in this chapter, Chatudvarnamaya system guna karma vibhaga. That is very essential. Varnasamala. Because we must have the aim of life. At the present moment, there is no aim of life. The aim of life is sense gratification. That's all. Indriyatik. That is forbidden in the shastra. Nunam pramatta kurute vikarma. King karmeti, king vikarmeti will be described. The karma and vikarma. Prescribed duties according to qualification, position, occupation. That is called karma. And just opposite, it is called vikarma. Karma, akarma, vikarma. That Krishna will explain. So, at the present moment, not at the present moment, it is the tendency of materialistic life to act vikarma. Forbidden karma. That is explained by Rishabhdev in Srimad Bhagavat. Nunam pramatta kurute vikarma. Jad indriya krita hai aprinoti. That is visible at the present moment in the Kali Yuga all over the world. Vikarmeti. All kinds of sinful activities that were performing. That is called vikarma. The vikarma, we have specified especially. Illicit sex, meat eating, intoxication, up to drinking tea, coffee and smoking, these are all vikarma. So they do not know, but they are going on. Therefore, Rishabhdev, Many, many years ago, he warned his sons, my dear boy, Nunam Pramatta Kurute Vikarma. Pramatta, pra means sufficiently or extraordinarily. Prakishta Rupena. Matta, matta means mad. Nunam Pramatta Kurute Vikarma. All people being mad, they are committing all sinful activities. They do not know what is sinful activity. They think everything is all right. No. Nature will take account of everything and he'll give you an excellent body. The same example, if you infect some disease and the after result, you must suffer from that disease. This is nature's law. Similarly, karanam gunasangasya sadasat janmajanishu. That is explained in Bhagavad Gita. Why one gets low-grade life and why one gets high-grade life? What is the reason? That is explained by Krishna. The karanam gunasangasya. The reason is, as he is being infected by the different qualities of material nature, therefore we have to be very careful. There are three qualities and mixed qualities. Originally three qualities, satagun, rajagun, tamagun. Then three multiplied by three mixture, then it becomes nine. Then nine multiplied by nine, it becomes 81. Different, just like color mixture. So therefore there are 8,400,000 of species of life. This mixture of quality. Karmana daimanatrena. We are infecting different types of qualities of material nature and we are becoming fit for the next life. But next life there is tatha dehantara prati. People do not know it. Therefore we should be very careful to take instruction from Bhagavad Gita and make our life successful, following the rules and regulations as it is prescribed there. Otherwise we are animals. The animals cannot follow any rules and regulations. Animal, you ask any dog that he become a brahmachari, that is not possible. That is not possible. It is for humanity. These ashramas, the four ashramas and four varnas, they're all meant for human society. Not that it is restricted in a certain area or certain country or certain community. No. It is meant for the whole human society. Bhagavad Gita is meant for the whole human society. When Krishna says, Chaturvarnam maya sistam gunakarma vibhagasa, he never says that it is meant for India. Where is that? Why they claim that the Chaturvarna should be in India? Krishna never said. Krishna says, sarvajanishu kaunteya sambhavanti murtaya. In every species of life, as many forms are there. All of them are my sons. Ahang bijapada pita. Krishna never said that I am Indian or I am Kshatriya or I am Brahmana. Krishna says, I am the father of everyone. Therefore, this chaturvarna or this karmakanda, everything is meant for the whole human society, if not for the animal society. Of course, animal society, they cannot follow. That is their degraded position. Labdha sudurlabham bahusammabhanti. Therefore, Shastra says that this human form of life is gotten after many, many births. Labdha sudurlabham. Sudurlabham. Durlabham means very rare to be obtained. And again, addition, su. Very, very. So you should not waste our this human form of life whimsically. It is a great loss. It is a great loss. But people are not educated. How much important this human form of life.
Don't move like that.
Labdha sudulla vaidam bahu sambhavanti manusam. And Prahlad Maharaj says also the same thing. That is the basic principle of Vedic civilization. Prahlad Maharaj says, Kaumaro acharit prakta dharmaan bhagavataniha. Duryavan manusam janma tadavi arthadam adhurvam. Kaumaro, from the very beginning of life, Kaumaro. Kaumaro means from 5th year to 10th year, 5 years. Within these 5 years, education must begin. And especially dharmaan bhagavatam. Bhagavatam, dharma means to understand Krishna, to understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead. I know amongst the Mohammedans, it is a system that the small children, they are taught Quran. That is a very good system. But we have forgotten, although India is the land of spiritual culture, our small children, they go to school, colleges, but he has no connection with Bhagavad Gita. He has no connection with Bhagavad Gita. They are simply trained up for sense gratification. In Western countries also, for sense gratification, which is to be suppressed. Sense gratification, that education is given. They do not know what is karma and what is vikarma. Now, when the students become disobedient and they create riots and set fire in the buses, and then they lament. But why you have educated the students like that? Who is responsible for this? The rascals, they do not know. Here is Krishna prescribing. Kim karma, kim akarma fi, kavayopi atra mohita. Even learned man, they become builder. Tatve karma purvaksham. So in this builder condition, baffled condition of the society, we should consult Krishna. Krishna is ready to give you advice. As he was ready 5,000 years ago to give advice to Arjuna. That instruction is still current. It is not that it is finished with the Arjuna and Krishna. No. You can take also the same advice from Krishna and mold your life. That is wanted. So, kurute bikarma. We are trained up simply to act opposite direction. Instead of doing good work, we have educated to do bad work. Just off. And that is not good. That is the advice of Vishabhya. Nunam pramatta. What is that bad work? Bad work means sense gratification. That's all. Anything you do for the satisfaction of your sense, that is bad work. And anything you do for satisfaction of Krishna, that is good work. This is the division of bad work and good work. The same thing, if you do for your personal satisfaction, it is bad work. And the same thing, if you do for satisfaction of Krishna, that is good work. We must first of all learn this. Just like Arjuna was thinking in the beginning that fighting and killing is not good, especially fighting with the family members and killing them. No, I cannot do it. Bad work. You are thinking it was bad. But same thing he did. When he understood Bhagavad Gita, he did not do anything else because he was a fighter, he was a warrior. In the beginning he was refusing, because he was trying to satisfy his senses. Oh, it is very good. I think it is. I think what you are. You are always misguided if you think like that. But the same Arjuna, when understood Bhagavad Gita, Krishna inquired from him, now what is your decision? Na karishye vachanam tava. Yes, now I have decided. So what is that vachanam tava? Krishna asked him to fight. The same fighting. How he became good now? Because Krishna wanted it. A good word. So this should be our motto of life. That you should act if Krishna is pleased. This is good work. That is confirmed in many places in Srimad Bhagavatam. Atapungvi Vijasresha Sutta Goswami said in the meeting of great learned scholars and Brahmins in the Nisharan. He said, Vijasresha, O best of the Brahmins, you are assembled here to hear me. Vijasresha, Atapungvi Vijasresha, Varnasama Vibhadasa. Again that Varnasama. Without Varnasama, it is a rascal society, that's all. It is not even human society, it is animal society. But that we have lost now. Again it is said, Varnasama Vibhadasa. Atapungvi Vijasresha. You are speaking amongst the very learned scholars and Brahmins. Therefore, you address, my dear, all great Brahmins, Vijasresha. Vija means Brahman, Kshatri, Vaishya. And the Brahmin is the Shrestha, the best of the Vijas. Vija means twice born. One birth by the father and mother, and the next birth through the Guru and Vedic knowledge. Vedic knowledge is the mother, and Guru is the father, the next birth. That is called Vija, twice born. Once born by father and mother, that is Shudra. Janmana jayate Shudra. First birth is Shudra. The next birth, when he is trained now by the Guru in Vedic knowledge, and that is real birth. Everything is clearly explained. If you take advantage of this Krishna consciousness movement, then our life will be perfect. That is the special prerogative of the Indians. Therefore Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Bharat bhumite manusya janma haila ja, janma sarthakari karo paropuka. Every Indian has to perfect his life by accepting the Vedic principle and distribute it to the whole world. This is the best welfare activities in the human society. Thank you very much.